So tell me what's wrong with feeling. I'm a flower, you're the bee. It's that shoulder that you need. I'm in love, I'm alive, I'm alive.
Just come out of Waiter's Way, and mate, when I tell you, an absolutely stunning coastline, like that thing was just unreal. Now, it was pretty exy to get in. It was about $40. That includes camping, obviously. But yeah, like well worth it in my opinion. I think Grace would agree. I think if you're coming down to the EYRE Peninsula, it'd definitely be worth the little bit of coin to get in. Yeah, we've just come out now. Last night was a pretty nice campsite. We were just in the sand dunes at the end towards Red Bank Beach. And there was like some fur seals just sitting down off the rocks, off the cliffs there. Yeah, that was a pretty spectacular sight as well. So we are just stopping off at the toilet and just kind of sussing where we're gonna camp tonight. Just looking at some free camps up on the west coast. So I'll travel north up there and see how we go. Okay, so we're just heading into Coffin Bay National Park now, just doing a bit of a day trip, just gonna have a little explore around and stuff, and then we're gonna head to possibly Granley Beach, which is just a little bit north of here, to camp, and we'll see how we go from there.
Yeah, it's $11 for a day pass into this national park, and you can just pay online, which is what we did.
Yeah, so last night we met this really nice couple from Victoria, just had them over for a few, drive to our little campsite for a few beers and that.
They had a really pretty,
Border collie. Yeah, called Ellie. So yeah, shout out to Sean and Caitlin if you ever see this. Probably won't, but you know.
You were really lovely. Yeah, yeah, really, really nice.
Just hit us up if you ever see this. Yeah.
Hi, Jam. That he said 14 or 15, very soft.
ended up having to go down to the beach to avoid oncoming traffic on the track, and we ended up getting bogged, and there was a bloke there with a shovel and a few extra max tracks to help us get out of there. And this is that.
Super windy and super dusty everywhere, but it's like the most sheltered spot we could find, and this is what we've got. So that's us for tonight, and yeah, I'm feeling super tired, but I have a heap of energy, so I think I might have a pretty early night, I reckon.
Are we going to have a late dinner?
Yeah, late dinner, early night. Yeah. We had a pretty late night last night because we stayed up talking to another couple that we met. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm pretty tired. I don't know. It's getting to me.
Talking about us really crashing today.
Oh, yeah.
Our escapades. We went to
Coffin Bay.
Coffin Bay on the four-wheel drive track there.
And we went around like kind of a B track, because on the main bit of the track there was like a massive like salt puddle that was like you couldn't go around it or anything. It was pretty deep, so not wanting to absolutely screw my car, we went around and it was like super soft sand, so I had to give it some, but the track was like heaps bumpy, so we ended up going like shaking and rocking and bouncing,
and it catapulted
the car over to the side like this, because we were coming around a corner at the same time,
yeah,
and it like catapulted into the air, and there was like a fence probably like this high, like just like little stumps like
kind of on the side of the track, and we literally like we went up like airborne and like cleared this like little wooden pole, and in the process I got some very brown underwear.
Oh yeah. No,
true,
we just
though.
Like
it was very scary.
We really did like nearly lose the car. We lost complete control of it. Well, Alex did, obviously. I had nothing to do with it. I was just sitting there. And that happened. And then we also got bogged, and we got helped by like three different blokes. Got Max tracks lent to us. We've got our own Max tracks, but we had to put four to, you know, to do the thing.
Had to do the thing.
Can you explain it?
Yeah. So we have two Max tracks. So these blokes lent us another two. So we had four. Which was very helpful. It would have taken us a lot longer to get out if they hadn't have been there, which was nice of them. So,
and then he, one of the blokes, we didn't even get his name, but he like helped us dig out the car and everything. He was really lovely.
Yeah, so he was a good bloke. And he was like helping recover other people and stuff as well, because there was heaps of people getting involved there. But yeah, so that was not ideal, but it was also good fun. We also lost one of the Max tracks like in the sand for a bit, because it was so, it got like buried down so deep after we went off it. Yeah, real deep in the sand. But we live and we learn.
Yep.
So
we pick better lines next time, don't we?
Yeah.
After getting unbogged and out of Coffin Bay, we followed the coast up north, just looking at the ocean, watching the waves, and just having a good old time. We were hoping to find a nice camp spot site somewhere along there, and we stumbled upon a little place just close to Greenlee Beach.
So that's it for this episode. If you liked the video, please like, subscribe and comment, and stay tuned for the last of this Eyre Peninsula trip.
It's fucking hot. Ow, what do you think? Burning my phalanges off.
Matt.
Alex and I, whoa! What are you doing? Not that way!
No,
it is that way. Oh, this way. God. Hi. Suck my toe.